Yeah, so welcome to Yoga with Smiles. And like you asked, what's the topic today? Today we are going to have a very interesting talk on goal setting. And we'll also talk about the third eye issues, okay, over here. So we are showing the connection between soft skills and your energy centers that you have. So every week we talk on a different energy center and the soft skills related with that. Okay. So now just imagine that you are, if I invite you and I say, come, let's go for a picnic. Okay. And I say, come, let's imagine that we are all sitting in the bus. Yeah. So I tell you, stand up. Come on, stand up, all of you. Stand up. Stand up right now. Your video is on so I can see you all. Okay. I say, stand up. Imagine you're in the bus.
I'm standing.
Okay. And then I say, okay, sit down in the bus. So sit down. Then I say, get down from the bus. Then I say, stand up again. Get into the bus. Then I say, sit down. Then I say, stand up. Then I say, sit down.
No bus?
Yeah, in the bus only. I tell you, enter the bus, climb the bus, get down, climb the bus, get down, climb the bus, get down. So imagine you were doing this day in and day out. Would you really listen to me? Or would you ask me some question? What question would you ask me? I can't hear you. You're on mute. Sorry. You have to unmute yourself. You'll ask me what is the reason. Okay. Any other question you'll ask me? You'll ask me what is the reason. Lorraine, what will you ask me?
I'll look like get up and get off and all. If there's a reason, I'll get off when my destination arrives.
Very good.
When I reach my destination, I'll get off.
So the question is, the question
is,
so the question that you'll ask me is, what is the destination? Correct? You always want to know what is the destination. Where are you heading? There is no fun in getting into a bus if all you're going to do in the bus is get up, enter the bus and get down. Enter the bus and get down without knowing the direction of the bus, without knowing your destination of your journey. So you have a problem in going up and down a bus. But do you realize, do we really have any idea of what is the destination of our life? Think about it. Every day we are just getting up from our bed. We are going around the day and then we are going back to bed and sleeping. And again we get up and we go around. And then we go back to sleep. And we get up and we go around doing whatever we're doing and we're going back to sleep. What difference between this and going into one bus up and down? Think about it. Yeah. Tell me. Your voice is not clear.
It's nice
to get up with some aim, isn't it? Instead of just getting up aimlessly and doing nothing. It's nice to have some purpose in life, isn't it? It's nice to have something to look forward to in life, isn't it? So this is just a simple example to show you how important it is to have something to look forward to. Did you get that? And for that, who's going to help you and who's going to support you in what you want to look forward to? It's you yourself.
First of all, we ourselves.
Correct. You yourself. It's you who has to decide what is the direction of your bus. It is you who have to decide, okay, what is the purpose of your life. Correct? It's you, you have to decide what is the goal of your life. Okay? And this is such an important aspect, huh? Yeah.
Yeah, giving us a reason. What is into this world for some reason.
Correct.
In our religion, we realize that God is our maker and He will guide us through our daily.
That is true. That is true. But you should know at least which is the direction you are heading. Okay. You leave the details to, you know, the higher power. But at least you should know which is the direction you're heading. You should know what is your goal in life. Okay. See, that's the thing about most of us. You know, most of us, we women, especially women, I feel, you know, once we decide that we want to go here, okay, it's very easy for us to actually do it. The problem that we have is most of the time we do not even know where we want to go. Okay? So, when in the day we spend so much of time in the doing it, but we don't spend time in planning it. Okay? So, that is our topic for today. We are going to talk about goal setting. Yeah? How it is so important for us to set our goals. Okay? Now, when you set goals, there are different areas of your life. So, tell me, what are the areas which you would like to set some goals about yourself? Okay? So, one of the most important areas is our physical health. Correct? Yeah? Who's responsible for your health? Only you. Nobody else. And if you don't take some kind of a...
Me, myself.
Yes. If you don't take some... If you are not clear about where you are heading, where your health is concerned, you know, suddenly tomorrow you will be faced with all kind of health issues. So, one of the goals you can write is about your physical health. Okay? Simple thing is, and one of the indicators for your health is your weight, you know, your sugar level or your blood pressure level or whatever it is. So, you can always say that, okay, today my weight is X, tomorrow my weight is going to be X. I mean, I want to lose at least 0.5 kg a week. Or, you know, I want to lose 1 kg a month. Whatever. You can put some goal and you need to be clear of your destination. Okay. So, in 1 month's time, I'm losing 2 kilos of weight. Now, if I have to lose that much weight, then you'll have to... The details you can work out later. But first, you have to be clear of what is it that you want. So, one area is health. Which is the other areas in which you can... And I want you... See, basically... This is very important that you spend time, and I would like you to do this alone or maybe with your partner, you know, but ideally you should do it alone and do it at a time when you're most relaxed and you're most creative, like early morning, you know, just write where you see yourself. Okay. So for example, your weight 1 month from now, where you see yourself 1 year from now, where you see yourself 3 years from now, where you see yourself 5 years from now. Okay, so what is the other area? Tell me another area. One is your health. What else? And you need to write down, okay? You need to actually physically write down on a piece of paper, you know, ideally with your hand and, you know, not on your phone or not on your laptop. With your hand on a piece of paper, actually write down what is your goal. So what is the next thing? What are the other areas you're going to write about? Tell me. Other than physical?
Learn something new.
Yes. Okay.
Mentally, keep myself mentally active.
Correct.
So for that, I need to learn some new, I need to learn some creative things so that it will activate my brain.
Very good.
And keep it, I'm mentally fit for many more years to come.
Very good. So the next thing is learning. So what you can do to keep your mental fitness, you know, make it sharper and sharper every day. Yes. So then just write, okay? So, I want to learn this course, I want to learn that course, or anything like that, you know. And, you know, what you can do to improve your creativity. Okay. What is the next one? Next. Spiritual life. Okay.
Spiritual life.
Spiritual life. What is it that you want in your spiritual life? Okay. So, every time how you can get connected to your higher power or whatever you're going to do about that. Any other areas? Okay. Any other areas? I know most of us, we are all 50 plus. So we have finished most of our, you know, professional life and our, you know, career part of it. But even then, okay, finance and career, that's another area. You still need to plan. You need to understand, okay, even if you do not work, you know, full time for the next 10, 20, 30 years, how are you going to manage your finances? Okay, how are you going to manage your career? Do you still want to be productive and do you still want to contribute in some way or the other? So finance and career goals, that can be another area. Anything else?
Yes.
Anything else? Think. All of them are so focused on serious things. What about your fun and relaxation? Yeah.
Fun things, traveling.
Traveling, yeah. Correct. Traveling, you know, so you make a goal. Like I have a goal that when I reach 60, I need so many countries I need to visit, or, you know, some goal you have to be, you have to, and I need to write it down. Okay. So recreation.
Yeah, that
so,
has already been, it yeah. has been completely stopped because of the pandemic.
Correct.
And last, I used to travel every month.
Yes, last 2 years with traveling is, but anyhow, but then now we should make it up. Okay, so maybe you can write a goal about that. So I want to show you all one thing. Okay, I don't know whether you can read it through the this thing. If you, I don't know if you can read it. Just see this. I don't know whether you can read what is there, okay? I found this paper recently. I had not seen it for so many years. Okay, I'll read it out to you. It says...
Are you reading it out?
Yeah, it says, thank you, universe, in advance for everything. Okay?
Oh my God.
Okay. And the date... Yeah, it's thank you, universe, in advance for everything. And this date is 20th of February, 2015. Okay?
Okay.
So I remember we had gone to, for one golfing trip. Okay? From Dubai, we had gone to a place called Russell Kema, and we were sitting in the hotel. And just out of the blue, we decided to write this. So the first is end 2015. I have a whole list of things.
Okay.
Then I have end... Okay. 2016. Then I have a whole lot of things that I have written. Then I have end 2017. Again, I have a whole lot of things written. And then I have written end 2018. I don't know whether you can see it. Okay, end 2018. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. You can see that? Okay. So again, I have written a whole lot of things. And on the last page, I wrote here. Okay. Now, now maybe we can read it. Thank you, universe, in advance. This is in the hotel. This is a hotel. The hotel, you know, pouch which was there, yeah. And it, I said, and we just signed it, Shobha. And see the date. It's 20th. Can you see the date? It's 20th February 2015. Okay. And I'd forgotten about this. Yeah, I'd forgotten about this. Okay, I'd completely forgotten about this. And it was just lying somewhere because we changed 3-4 houses after that. And recently I found this. Okay. And trust me, 99% of whatever we have written, okay, has come true.
You've achieved.
Yes, 99%. 99%.
That's nice.
Yeah, because I wrote it.
And what did you write? Yeah. Traveling, mostly traveling.
So many things. So because we were in a different state of life that time. We were in Dubai that time. And I'd written about moving to Mangalore and so many things and everything. So a lot of things, you know, have actually happened here. The point which I'm telling you is that whatever tips I give you, I have actually practiced it myself. Okay? So every birthday, I generally write something about where I see myself next 1 year from now. Birthday is a good time, or a wedding anniversary is a good time, you know, to do it together. So just sit and write. Okay? And when you write, you have to be clear that it's going to happen. The what, when, where, why, how, your higher power will make it happen, you know. But your work is to be clear about what is the direction your life is taking for the goals in life, okay. So we all have our big goals and our small goals and our short-term goals and our long-term goals. And, you know, my point is just to make you aware, okay, please spend some time with yourself and please write about what direction you want your life to go in the next, you know, 1, 3, 5 years, you know. So that's what we did. But 3 years is what we wrote that time. 3 or 4 years is what we wrote over there. Okay. So this is about goal setting. Now, all of us, we have, okay, this is just about to see where your direction is there. But I want to ask you another question. You know, are we come here just with, like, you know, I think we somebody mentioned that right at the beginning of this session. You know, we really want to know, we don't want to be aimless. We are here. Why are we come on this earth? We have come here for a higher purpose. So this is one energy center. Actually, I wanted to do the other five energy centers and then talk about this. Okay. So if you see my earlier videos, see the videos about activating all the other five energy centers. Okay. So every week I do a different energy center, but you have to make sure those five are fully activated. And then I talk about this energy center. Okay. So make sure you do that work first and then you work on this. So this is the sixth energy center and this is called the third eye, the Ajna chakra or the third eye chakra. You know, we have these wheels. So we have violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. So this is a indigo color, dark blue color, and we call it the third eye energy center. And you need to really work. And why is it called the third eye? See, third eye is like having the third eye can see, your eyes can see up to one distance, but the third eye can see much further. So you can see, so third eye is what gives you clarity of vision. Okay? So once you activate this, you will really come, you will actually basically see in advance. See, everything what happens in this world happens two times. It's like an architect. You know, first he draws the plan on the paper and then it comes in, manifests in the world. Yeah. So all the big people who created so many things, they have all visualized it first in their head. And after visualizing it in their head, then it actually manifests in the real world. So my work today is just to inform you that it's very important to visualize in advance. So these goals, you know, about your career or finances or health, these are all, you know, at a different level. But more than that, you need to ask the question, okay, what is your purpose in life? You know, I took a lot of time to really work and understand. Imagine you had all the money in the world and imagine all your goals were fulfilled, you know, then what? What is it that you would like to do? What is it that you would like to contribute? What is your bigger purpose in life?
I want to make a difference in society.
Yes. So there are many ways.
Make a difference in somebody's life.
Correct. So there are many ways in which you can make a difference in life, you know. And this is all about
want to give back to society.
Correct. So we all have got that bigger purpose, okay? But we can get clarity of how to achieve that purpose, okay? When we actually make goals, you actually need to take action. So this gland which is here, which is between your two eyebrows at the bridge of your nose, okay? There is something called the pineal gland. I don't know whether you have learnt about it in school. This is one gland which has not been really publicized much about, but it's a very, very important gland. Okay, if there are imbalances over here, you have all issues regarding physical issues regarding this area, you know, headaches and migraines and, you know, all stress and all around this part. Okay, so you need to, if your third eye energy center is imbalanced, okay, you're going to get a lot of, you'll feel confused and, let me put it the other way around, okay? If you have a strong third eye over here, this energy center is strong, then it builds up your power of intuition, your knowledge, your creativity. All that gets empowered when you work on this pineal gland, this third eye chakra. And this mention of, see, scientifically, I do not know how much research has been done. But I am talking about the wisdom given by our Hindu sages in so many years. The Egyptians, they had something called the Eye of the Horus. If you ask all the civilizations, always talk about this extra third eye power that you have. And this gets activated, okay, in the dark. This is the pineal gland which gives melatonin. And melatonin is produced in the dark. That is why they ask you to sleep in complete darkness. They say don't sleep with the light on.
Yes.
You know? And so
yes.
Yeah. So yeah. In the dark, the reason why I'm doing this session today is because we are going to teach you some ways of activating this third eye in our next yoga session. Okay, so our next yoga, so one of the ways in which you activate your third eye chakra is by doing candle gazing. Candle gazing. Okay, so for the next yoga session on Tuesday, please come with your candles, and in a dark room, you need to put the curtains on and sit in an absolutely dark room, and we will be doing that those exercises. So you'll have eye issues, you'll have headache issues, you'll have all these issues if this part of your third eye chakra is imbalanced. Okay, so one of the ways in which you heal it is by doing the candle gazing. It's called Trataka, and we are going to do that in the Tuesday session. Okay, and the color associated with this is indigo, dark blue, okay, or maybe somewhat like purple or whatever it is. You have to imagine that there is a wheel, dark blue wheel, moving front and back, okay, in your in the area between your eyebrows. So what you need to do is you need to close your eyes, okay. And another way, so there are different ways in which you have to work on getting this chakra balanced, okay. So one of the ways is, like I told you, doing the candle glazing. Another way of doing that is by meditation, okay. So meditation is a very important aspect. So most of the time, whenever we meditate, don't they tell us, okay, close your eyes, focus on your point between your eyebrows, don't they tell you that, okay. That's where they're asking you to focus on that. And you have to imagine there's a blue wheel moving front and moving back. And you have to be in absolute gratitude. Okay, so this is one meditation. I told you I've been doing it since so many years for all the seven. It's a gratitude meditation activating all the seven chakras. So you activate this. You close your eyes and you say, I want you to do this with me and repeat after me. Imagining this thing. Close your eyes, everybody. Close your eyes and imagine this point which is in between your eyebrows, just above the bridge of your neck, of your nose. Keep looking over there, and actually if you concentrate, you can actually see one eye looking back at you, you know. And you just say with intense gratitude, you say, thank you for the clarity of my goals and my vision. Thank you for the clarity of my goals and my vision. Thank you for the clarity of my goals and my vision. Don't open your eyes. Keep your eyes closed till the end of the session today. Now, another way in which you can activate is by doing the Anulom Vilom Pranayama exercise. But now when you're doing it, think that you're taking your breath up to your eyebrow, middle of your eyebrows, okay. So take a deep inhalation from your, I'm sure you all know how to do this Anulom Vilom. Chin mudra in the left hand, right hand you hold this Nasika mudra, and close your right nostril. Start with breathing from the left nostril. Take a deep breath inside. Inhale, and when you're inhaling, think that the breath is going right up to your middle of your eyebrows. Take a deep inhalation. Concentrate now on the eyebrow, third eye area. Hold on to the eyebrow for some time. And then exhale on the other side. Again, take a deep inhalation. Hold on to the point between your eyebrows. Take a deep exhalation on the other side. We'll do this for 9 counts silently. Two, three. Five, six, seven. Nine. Don't open your eyes. Keep focusing on the point between your eyebrows. Keep imagining there is a third eye there looking back at you. Or there is a spinning wheel which is indigo in color going round and round. There is a Bija mantra. Bija mantra, we have different mantras for different, all the different chakras. And the Bija mantra for this third eye chakra is again Om. So in your mind, all loudly if you want, you can say Om 9 times. Rub your palms, put it on your eyes, looking at your palms. Another way in which you can activate is, you know, we always do a namaskara pose, we do. So when you do a namaskara pose, you're putting your forehead on the ground. That's another way in which you can activate this and this third eye chakra. Okay, so very simple, very nice, and eat a lot of blue color foods like berries, brinjals, you know, the normal natural foods, as much as possible eat natural foods. Okay, and one of the ways in which third eye gets calcified, the pineal gland gets calcified, is by use of fluoride. So as far as possible, don't use water which has fluoride. Okay, don't use toothpastes that have fluoride. Okay, use non-fluoride water and non-fluoride toothpaste if you can. Okay, these are small things, but it makes a big difference. I have switched to a natural, you know, toothpaste, and make sure that your water is not, you know, fluoride water. You can get a water dispenser which can take out the fluoride from there. So that way, so, and you know, it is such a pleasure to enjoy doing these small tips, you know, and work with yourself. And it takes time, it won't happen immediately. That's why I told you, first work on the other five chakras. It takes time, but then once this chakra is opened, your intuition and your knowledge and your, you know, your inner knowledge, your gets really enhanced here. Okay, this is the seat of intuition and knowledge. Yeah, so I hope you'll enjoy the session. I look forward to seeing you again.
Yes.
And please write down and spend time with yourself and get your direction, get your purpose in life. Okay, so thank you, and I'll see you on Tuesday with your candles and your dark rooms.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you so much.
Yeah.